In this video, we're going to look at a legal problem called find duplicate subtrees. So given the root of a binary tree, return all duplicate subtrees. So for each kind of duplicate subtrees, you only need to return the root node of any one of them. So two trees are duplicate if they are the same structure with the same nodes and values, right? So let me give you an example. If you have an example like this, where we have a binary tree, right? You can see that this node right here is the same as this node, right? Because they have the same value and they have the same structure, right? This node, the left node of this node is a node 4, and the left node of this node is node 4, right? And the left node of this node is null, and the right node of this node is null. The right node of this node is null, which is also the same as structure as this, right? But however, though, if I have this kind of thing, right? In this case, they're not the same because they don't have the same structure, because you can see that there's additional node on this node right here. This node has a right child of 6 and this node has a right child of null, right? So they do not have the same structure, and therefore we cannot be able to therefore they're not a duplicate subtree, right? A duplicate subtree basically means that the entire subtree will be identical with the other one, right? So now you can see that basically, you can see the output, we have two nodes, right? The one of them is this node right here, which has a left child node 4. And the other node is basically node 4, which basically has no children at all, right? So in this case, we basically have total of two duplicate subtrees, right? So because you can see that this node right here is a counted subtree as well. And then you can see also we have another example, right? Which is example 2. And you can see in this example too, I have this node right here, and then I have a left child and a right child. And in this case, because there's no, because the only duplicate subtree that we have is just basically this one, right? Because we have node 1 here and node 1 here. So we just put a list of node 1, right? Basically, we're returning a list of tree node, which is basically just node 1. And then you can also see that we have another example, like, you can see we have this, right? Which is pretty much the same as the previous one, right? So basically you can see that we must have the same structure and then the same values. If there's a situation where the subtree does not have the same structure or the same value, right? If I have this node right here, it's a different value, for example, node 6 or anything, then they're not identical, right? So you get an idea. And then now let's take a look at the constraints. So you can see the number of nodes in the tree will be in range from 1 to this, right? So we know that for sure that this tree will at least have one node, okay? And then the values is basically between negative 200 to 200 value, right? So how can we be able to solve this problem? So the brute force approach to solve this problem, which I think is a lot easy to figured out, is basically we extract all the nodes, right? Each and every single nodes that we have in our subtree onto a list, right? Just like how we do it in a list or array, right? We basically put each and every single node, like node 1, node 2, node 4, right? Node 3. It doesn't matter. We can do BFS or DFS, do a search to extract each and every single node out of it and save it onto a list. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do a brute force approach for each and every single node, right? We're going to do a compare, right, to see if they have the same node, right? And I think it's pretty easy to do. We basically we can have a function that takes node 1 and node 2, and then we basically check to see if they're the same, right, have the same value. If they don't have the same value, we return false. And then what we're going to do is we're going to check its children, right? In this case, we compare node1.left, right, with node2.left. And then we also want to make sure we check node1.right, right? So we're just going to do this using recursion. Basically, we're just going to check to see if they have the same structure and the same values, right? If they are a duplicate subtree. If they're not, we basically don't add it to the result list, right? This is our result list that we're going to return at the end. We can have a global variable list of tree node, and then if they don't, if this like this condition, right, doesn't, if we do a recursive call, right, to check to see if two subtree are the same or not. If they are the same, we add it to the list. If they are not the same, we don't add it to the list, right? So you can see that this approach will pretty much give us a time complexity of n to the power of three, right? Basically n cubed, right? Because in this case, you can see for each and every single iteration, right? So basically we using a nested for loop, right, to iterate, compare each and every single node, right, each and every single pairs, right, and then for each and every single pair, we have to, you can see we have to do a linear scan, right, or pretty much like a tree traversal, right, for this subtree, for this current subtree, to see if those two subtrees are the same. So you can see that at the end of it, by the end of it, we basically get a big O of n to the power of three, right? So how can we be able to optimize our previous approach, right? We know that the previous approach gave us a time complexity of big O of n to the power of three. So how can we be able to even optimize this this time complexity? So in this case, what we can do is we can use serialization. So a couple videos ago, or actually a lot of videos ago, I made a video called Serialize and Deserialize on my channel. And basically I talk about how we can be able to serialize a tree, right, a binary tree, and then deserialize it. Serialize a binary tree to a string, and then we're using that string to deserialize it back to the binary tree, right? And what we can do here is we can be able to serialize it, right? Serialize each and every single subtree into a string, and then we can save that onto our table or a set. Right. Every time when we see, okay, well, we've seen another or current tree, once we serialize it, we know that the string that we serialize the current subtree is already contained in our set. Then we know that that's a duplicate subtree, right? So what we can do is that we can be able to add that duplicate subtree node onto the list of tree node, right? And basically, we want to make sure we add non-duplicate nodes, right? Because there you can see we have three or four, and there could be many duplicates, or more than two, more than three, more than four duplicates subtrees. So at the end, we basically want to make sure we return we want to make sure to keep track of just only one duplicate subtree, right? Or the root of the duplicate subtree node. So basically, the idea is that what we can do to optimize this is that for each and every single node, right? So in this case, node one, I can serialize this, right? Serialize this entire subtree will look like something like this, like one, and the left subtree is two. Two has a left subtree of four, and then right subtree of null. We can use x to represent that, right? Which again, I talk about that in the serialize and deserialize video. I'll put a link on the info card. You can take a look. But basically, you can see once we serialize the right left subtree, we can serialize the right subtree. So we have 3, 2, 4, and then two has a right subtree of null, right? And then three has a right subtree of four has left subtree of x, and you get an idea, right? Once we serialize that, we can save it onto a set or whatever, and then we move on to nest node, right? And then we basically serialize this and then save it onto the hash set, serialize this, save it onto hash set, and then you can see we serialize this subtree, save it onto hash set, serialize this subtree, save it onto hash set, serialize this subtree, save it onto hash set. And basically you can see this will give us a time complexity of big O of n squared. The reason why we have an n squared time complexity is because for each and every single node, we pretty much have to traverse the entire tree or subtree to serialize it, right? So in this case, we're visiting each and every single node to try to serialize each and every single node and save it onto a set or a table, right? But still, once we visit each and every single node, we have to also traverse the remaining subtree, or in this case, the remaining tree to serialize it into a string, right? So that will also give us a linear time complexity as well. So that's basically big O of n squared. So how can we be able to, you know, improve the time complexity even more? So when we deal with tree problems, I think it's very, very important to always have this concept or always remember all the methods or all the ways that we can be able to traverse a tree, right? We know we can be able to traverse the tree using pre-order traversal, right? Or from top to down, but we can also be able to traverse the tree from bottom to up, right? So what we can do is that instead of just going from the top to the bottom, like for each and every single node, we serialize this. For each and every single node, we serialize that. What we can do is that we can be able to start at the bottom, right? So once we build this subtree, we return the serialized version of this to the parent. I know that the left subtree because I already returned that, and I also know the right subtree because I already called that too, and I can be able to build it, in this case, in a linear time complexity, right? So we're going from the bottom to the top, and we're basically traversing each and every single node once, right? And then we're still doing the same thing. We're still using serialization. Basically, we can be able to improve the time complexity pretty much using big O of n. So let me show you the code. So to do this in code, basically what I have here is I have a final, or in this case, a constant variable called not a tree, right? Or in this case, not a tree, right? Basically, I use x to represent null, right? So if I have a node, in this case, if I have a node and this node has null value, right? So we can use x to represent that. And then you can also see that we have a hash set to keep track of all the visited, right? So basically stores, once we serialize this subtree into a string, we basically use a visited hash set to keep track of that. And then we also have a map, right? In this case, a map basically keep track of duplicate subtree, right? In this case, we do not want to just like use a list of tree nodes to store that. What we need to do is we need to use a table, right? Use a table to store these nodes, right? We want to store just only one duplicate subtree node, right? We don't want to store a bunch of duplicate subtree node, like node 4, node 4, node 4. Like, we do not want to do that, so that's why we use a table. And then you can also see that inside our main function, this is our main function, we're using post-order traversal. Remember, post-order traversal, we traverse its children first, so the left side, the right side, and then we visit the current node, right? And the pre-order traversal is the opposite. We traverse the current node, the left side, the right side. So in this case, we do post-order traversal. Once we traverse it, we're basically returning a linked list. Or in this case, a list of tree node. And in this case, this list of tree node will have all the nodes or all the values that we have in our table, right? So in this case, you can see in our post-order traversal function, right? Basically, what we have here is we first, like I said again, we traverse the left, then we traverse the right, right? And then this will basically return us the left subtree. Okay, and then this will return us the right subtree. Initially, we don't know if this node has a left or the right. We basically use NT, right? Like I said again, it's basically not a tree, right? A string that represents not a tree for the left subtree and the right subtree. So what's gonna happen is that we know that once we build our left subtree and a right subtree, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna use a string builder, append the current node's value. And then we use a comma to separate that, right? And you can see that if the current node on the left is null, then we can just have X, right? Which pretty much means null, right? And then we use a comma to separate that. And then the right subtree. Okay, so once that's done, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use, convert the string builder to a string, which basically is the current subtree. Now we wanna see if can be able to save the duplicate subtree, right? You can pretty much like do this in here, but I basically extract it out. basically what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to see if this visit is already visit this key, right? In this case, if it already visited this key before, because now this is our serialized version of our current subtree, if we already visited that before, then we can add it onto our table, right? So what's gonna happen next is that we can be able to visit that, right? Or in this case, we can get the visited hash set at the current subtree. And then we kind of return the current subtree string back to the root, right? So that basically we're just going from the bottom to the bottom, from bottom to up, right? And we're building the serialized version of our current subtree as we go, right? And this will ensure that we can be able to reduce time complexity to linear, because we're only traversing the tree once, each and every single node once. And as we traverse from the bottom to the top, we're basically just gonna check, right? For each and every single, in this case, for each and every single recursion call, we check to see if the current tree structure is duplicate. If it is, like I mentioned before, right? If the current subtree, right? This is our current subtree. If it's duplicate, we just add it onto our result, right? We're onto our table, right? And at the end, like I said again, we basically return all the values, all the tree node, right, in our hash table. Okay, so this is basically how we solve this problem. And again, time complexity is big O of n. N is number of nodes that we have in our tree. Okay, so there you have it, and thank you for watching.